In this lesson, we'll talk about how to add effects and filters. First, let's look at our video before and after adding effects and filters. It's extremely easy to add effects to CapCut. Just tap an effect to apply it. First, tap Effects in the bottom toolbar. You'll see two options, Video Effects and Body Effects. Tap Video Effects, and you'll see lots of free effects that are trending on TikTok. Select one you like to see how it looks in the preview. Tap the check mark to go back to the editing page. You can now see the effect track. The effect is only shown in the part of the video that the effect track covers. Tap and hold the middle of the effect track with one finger to move the effect. Tap and hold the white bookends to change the length of the effect. To add more interest, you can add more than one effect at once. For example, with this video, we can tap Effects again, then Video Effects, and add the Stellar effect. Now both effects will be applied to the video. The other effects category is Body Effects. These effects can be applied to the human body. You can try them yourself. They work in the same way as the video effects. Now we've looked at effects. Let's talk about how we can change the color tone of the video using Adjust and Filters. If you are new to colors, it's generally better to add a filter first and then adjust the tones. First, let's look at filters. There are tons of free filters in different categories to choose from. You can select a filter that is right for your style of video. If your video is about food, then you can select a filter from the Food category. If your video is a nature video, then select one from the nature category. Each category has a number of different filters. Tap a filter to try it out and find the right one for you. In this video, we'll use Honey Peach. After we've selected it, we can move the white circle along the green slider above to change its intensity. The default filter intensity is 100%. Move the circle left to reduce the intensity. Tap the check mark to go back to the editing page. You will see that a filters track has been added. Tap and hold the filter track to move the filter. Move the white bookends to apply the filter to more or less of the video. Normally, if you only have one video clip, the filter should be added to the entire video so that the tone stays consistent. If you have lots of clips, each clip might have a different quality of light. So even if you add the same filter, the tone will not be consistent. In this case, we might want to adjust the colors for each clip. Next, let's look at how to adjust the colors of each clip. First, select the video, then tap Adjust in the toolbar below. You'll see lots of different settings you can adjust. Here, we'll talk about a few of the most common ones. Brightness, contrast, saturation, temperature, and sharpen. First, tap Brightness. We can see that there is a slider that allows us to adjust the brightness. Move the circle left to reduce the brightness, and move it right to increase it. Generally, if the video was shot too dark, then we want to increase the brightness. If the video is too bright, we want to reduce it. Contrast is used to make bright areas brighter and dark areas darker, thereby increasing the contrast between the two. If we move the circle right, the contrast will increase. Saturation can be used to make colors more vivid, so let's dial it up a bit. Sharpen is used to make video details and lines more distinct. If we sharpen our video, it'll look a bit clearer, so let's sharpen it a little. Last but not least is temperature. Tap Temp and then move the circle left to make the video look bluer and colder. This cold tone makes the video sharper and more serious. Move the circle right to increase the red tone. This makes the video look warmer, and a warmer tone is generally happier. No one setting on its own can work magic. Try out different changes with different videos to learn how best to use color. Everything we looked at today, from effects to filters and color adjustments, can all work to strengthen your video. But don't use effects and adjust colors just to show off your technical skills. Make sure they really add something. Next time, we'll be looking at transitions and animations. See you then!